Hello, my boys, I have a surprise for you. So people ask me to create a very profitable Atlas setup for new players that can bring you good profit, you know? I already had one that was for League Star Scenario, which helped you to unlock your bonus objectives and to get early currency very fast. But here you want to make real profit, like real, really nice profit. And I made a setup for you. But before you jump into it, I want to show you something very funny. Here on the Discord, someone just found from a Strongbox 2 Mirrors of Kalanta. Just now it happened. And it's very funny. Yeah, grats to him, man. Very happy. I'm very happy for him. He did a Strongbox setup from the League Start Atlas. So here I explain. We must League Start, we will do Strongbox setup. You can put Scarabs. I explain like this. On day 2, I was farming those special Strongboxes. On day 2 of the league, early. And they were 20 kills. They were very cheap. But later people caught up that it's very profitable and the price is skyrocketed. Now that Scarab is more than 100 kills, so it's no longer profitable. But enough talking already, I'll show you this Atlas here. Before we jump into the setup, I need to tell you that for new players, you want to prioritize maps that can drop jackpot divination cards. For example, in Crimson Temple you can get Apothecary, Mirror Shard card and the Enlightened. Here you can get in Wastepool the Doctor. You know? Here you can get the Doctor also. Here you can get, Apothecary. So you want jackpot divination cards. You will run your content in such maps. You will favor them and you will focus on them. Because we will also run a very cheap Scarab that will grant 150 more divination cards in your maps. My setup is very cheap. It's low investment. The Scarab that we are using are very cheap. Because I don't want to pay a lot. I'm a greedy man, you know? Let's jump into the setup here. Basically, it's a ritual with a twist, because we're gonna use a Scarab. This is noob friendly. If you don't have a strong build, don't worry. Your build can do everything here. We will do Blight, of course, because this will also help you to get a lot of levels. Because it's still League Start. League just started. You want to get more levels and some more currency. So Blight will remain for now. And Ritual here with more points. You also have here more increased effect. This will guarantee more pack size, more item quantity, more item rarity inside your maps, which is nice because we want to get more loot. Here it's an interesting note. This from time to time you will get better tier uniques that you can sell. It happened multiple times to me. So this note, I like it. I will take it always. And here for the Eater of Old Altars, you want more pack size, which is great. Again, if you're doing Siege Ballista, it can do all the modifiers from Eater of Old Altars. Very easy, very nice. Okay, my boys, here also we want up to 5 rare masters are possessed, so they drop more stuff. Nothing fancy, all is good. Yeah. So, let's talk about the Scarabs that we use for this strategy. As I explained, we use cheap Scarabs. Yeah, we put the Ritual here, just this one first, which is very cheap. Very, very cheap, 1 kills. Or 2 if you buy in bulk. This will allow you to reroll one more time. Basically, we can reroll in Ritual now 5 times for items. We can fish for items 5 times, man. I also have here divination cards. Divination here. And for the last one, you pick whatever you want. These two are very cheap. Up to you. I don't want to pay much because I'm a greedy man. I don't want more. Yeah, for the maps, you can run Crimson Temple, Burial Grounds, Defile Cathedral, what you want. I'm gonna take one here. And we run it. Let's identify it. Okay, we do this one. We put the Scarabs. Hey! Put this one. We put this one. And this is... Why not? We put it. We put this one also. I want to see here that you have 72% item quantity. Look what happens with this Atlas. Here, you just take the default one because you don't want to pay. You're a greedy man like me. We put that. We hit it. We want to do a map showcase fast. Yeah, we do a map showcase. Look, item quantity 121 and pack size. Because of that last setup, you will get extra item quantity, which is nice. Okay, let's do this altar. Okay. Man, I need to go in the kitchen. I need to be fast. I need to go in the kitchen. I forgot food on the oven. I'll try to be fast. Oh, man. No. I need to be fast. Here, I made a guide yesterday if you want to know how to do it easy. Okay. I'll put it in the description of this video, so if you want to do Blight inside your maps on easy mode, you can watch that video. Come on, I need to be fast. Good. Come on. I forgot food on the oven. I hope it's... I need to be fast. Else I won't have nothing to eat today. Come on. Let's clear this. Okay, and clear this fast. Come on. Good. Okay, let's check the loot. This is 10 kilos, like 15 kilos, like this here. Here we check for golden oils. Man, and we also get good experience, doesn't have golden oils. Oi. No. Okay, I'm wrong, I'm gonna rush it. Let's go for the ritual altars. Okay, this is nice. 50 kilos, I'll take it, why not? Okay, here is another one. Okay, let's start it. Hey, one more at the top. Okay. Okay, here we have a 6th link. And we can start price checking. Let's see this one. Ooh. That's a rare unique. Okay, but it's cheap, we won't take it. Okay. No. 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 You see, you can roll multiple times, which is very nice, man. Sadly, we didn't got anything expensive, which sucks. So I'll go to here, kill the boss, and they'll I'll come back. I'll do another map after I come back, you know. Yeah, you can also get the apothecary. We have good item quantity. We have a divination scarab. You can get it. I got 7 years of bad luck 3 times already. Okay, I want to show you one more thing first. Before I go to the kitchen, I need to show you one more thing. So here you can make a lot of profit with the blighted maps, you see? This one you can sell in bulk for more profit. You can go to golden oils. You can use the oil extractors trick. You can get the jackpot divination cards at the pump when they do the explosion. Here it's what I got in 2 hours of running. I ran a ritual. This strategy I ran it for 2 hours. This is what I got from ritual. Here how you price check fractured items. You click here on the base item. You see this is 1.5 divine orbs. Very easy, very nice. This is a jackpot that I found in ritual. You see, it's worth a lot. It's like 10, 11 divine orbs. This, I found a divine orb. You will find omens. This is 30 kios. Some omens are very expensive, like the 6 link card. Here we have a synthesized items. Again, you will price check it like this. Okay, this is 50 kios orb. Very sexy, very nice. Here it's with mana. See? This is like free for the device. So there are a lot of things that you can find. You need to get used to look for fractured item, then sensitized items. You check for the implicit. Man, this is very profitable. If you trust me and you see my previous guys, you know that I'm very serious when it comes to profit. People ask me like 2 days ago and I said, boss, wait. So I did a lot of experimentation with harbingers, with strong boxes, and they require a lot of investment because with very expensive scarabs. But this is a very cheap strategy. You will use very cheap scarabs, and it's also fun and easy to play, you know. It's not like Guardian Maps, which, by the way, I did experiment with Guardian Maps, but a lot of builds and new players cannot do them at the moment, especially with this. I will talk about them is Saturday, I think. But until they'll stick with my setup here, I will put the Atlas setup in the comments pinned. Have fun, boys, and enjoy. I'll go in the kitchen. Good luck.